I bless you for joining us. We're about to get started for our refreshing this morning. So any of those that are hearing us that have not had an opportunity to join us and have listened to this recording, you have an opportunity to share this recording with someone else to bless them. So God bless you for joining us. Take along for this refreshing song. And make this song get personal.
I can have everything.
Giving up. Thank you, Daddy. Whatever God refresh the song to wake us up. And so I bless God this morning because I am going to have everything, no matter what it looks like. The devil is crazy. And so I just thank you, Lord, this morning that you're still abiding with us, Father. So this morning, our speaker is going to be Dr. Pamela Porter. And we'll take a moment to look at the word for the morning that comes from 1 Peter 5 and 10. It says, the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will himself restore you and make you strong, firm, and steadfast. I want to say good morning again to her and Apostle, anyone else on the call. We're going to hear another song. And then we'll release Apostle to give us the prayer request a minute and take those down. And then you'll hear from Dr. Pamela. So you wanted to take a minute and do that after I play the second song, or you want to give us some message, as I said. Let's just go ahead and get the good mornings through, and then any introductions and good mornings. And then we'll go ahead on and take any list of those people who have prayer requests, and I'll play that song.
Okay. Good morning. It's a blessing to be able to rise up early and seek our God. So those that have prayer requests, would you give me the names and the information? I know Michael Morgan. We're going to pray for all of the ministries that's affiliated with ELST, and for all of the leaders and everywhere, those are the fivefold ministry. Are there any prayer requests this morning?
Anyone on with any special prayer requests before we go into our intercession this morning? We still have the list. We're just not calling out all the names.
I was gonna write down the new names. I didn't have that list with me. I'm not at home.
I have the list here.
All
the names again.
Okay.
Is there any new requests so we can add those to the list? Because we're praying.
Right.
Yeah, we made that clear at the very beginning. We won't repeat the names over and over again, but we want to make sure everybody knows those names on the list when we first call them out.
Right, okay.
Is there anything new that anybody wants to add before we intercede? Nothing new? Well, you're going to be blessed by our instructor today. She's going to be teaching us on watch number 3 so you can get prepared for pens and pads, prepare for that. And meanwhile, before we get started, since we are just at our 6 o'clock hour, we'll prepare now to hear our song for the morning. God bless you. Ready. Thank you, Lord. You're so wonderful. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. So I'll get you positioned for prayer and walk. Thank you, Daddy.
And we lift you up.
I thought about when I woke up. With the crush still in my eyes and my body saying go to sleep, I thought about somebody might even do that. And I said, you're so holy, you're so wonderful. So we lift you up, Daddy. Thank you.
Okay, let us pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
Yeah, Daddy.
As it is in heaven, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us all our sins. Jesus, we come. Thank you for what you've done.
Spiritual activity going on in the midnight hour. Your faith will be strengthened during that time if you're praying and seeking God and studying His Word. Because along with prayer, a lot of times you have to pull out your Bible. You pray, and then the Lord will speak to you through His Word. And then, you know, you thank Him for what He's shown you or whatever He's told you. And this is also a time when most demonic parts happen in the midnight, especially witches and warlocks and Satanists, and they're having fun starting their incantations. And incantations is just a series of words, magic spells or charms, or sometimes people would say chants, or sometimes they even sing words, like when they're trying to speak a spell over a person and stuff. That's why the saints need to be on their guard and doing their watching hour. We also know in the month of October, that's when a lot of the witches, warlocks, and others are considered their holiday month, the month of October. When that's also the time when children are missing, and they also take animals and use their blood for their spells and stuff. And so that's why the saints really need to be on their watch during the, this time, especially the month of October. This watch is for experienced intercessors, those who know how to pull down Satan's kingdom and take authority that God has given us to use to war in the heavenlies. You know, you need to know how to pull down and war. And even the Lord will warn you when things are about to approach maybe your family or at this particular time. And we need to know how to go in and war. And we know in the Word of God, sometimes the enemy just tries to, a lot of times he does things, but if we're not on our watch, he'll catch us off guard. And in 1 Kings 3 and 20, we know about the lady that rose in midnight, and she had rolled up on her son, and he died, and they went to Solomon, because the other handmaiden, she was trying to play like the child that was alive was hers, and Solomon had great wisdom, and he said, let's take a sword and cut the child in half and split it. And we know the woman who wasn't the mother child said, okay, okay. But the real mother, she wanted to leave the child whole, so she said she could have it. So Solomon knew who the wise mother was. And I was bringing this up because when we are children of God, God gives us wisdom of how to do things and what to do. And I admire some things that Solomon did and other people of the Bible, if we just read our lessons and learn from them. But also, we know in Psalms 91 and verse 5, it tells us to do not be afraid of the terror of the night, nor the fear of the dangers of the day. So God is telling us we don't have to be fearful. We just look unto Him, the Father, the one who He told us to look to Him. If we're praying in the midnight hour and praying during the day, we don't have to fear. We don't have to live in, with a spirit of fear, because God has already gave us the solution. And this watch is for those who are not afraid during the third watch. We are not afraid. We put on our spiritual armor. We are able to pray against satanic attacks over our life or our friends or the people that we're praying for, our family members, our marriages, our churches, our community, and our nation. Our nation is in trouble today, and we need to be praying for all of these things. And I don't know about you, but sometimes when you're praying for your community, the Lord will show you certain areas where we need to drive around and pray over that area. Even lately on my watch, the Lord has me even to call the police about certain things that was happening in my area, and I did. I reported it. We're not supposed to be Christian to just lay aside and do nothing. God wants us to take action today. It's time out for the saints of letting Satan take havoc in our communities, in our homes, and we don't do nothing but set back. We have to have on the whole armor. We got to say what the Word of God say and start doing something. We can't just sit back anymore. Time is set our day before it really begins. And during our intercessory prayer time, You can stop the devil and his demons from causing accidents, crashes, and loss of job, and death before time. I don't know about you, but it's been times God has warned. It even happened to myself a couple of years ago. I was warring in the heavenlies, in the spirit realm, for my grandchildren. And little did I know, later on that day, a man tried to grab my grandson. He was about 9 years old, off the school campus. But my grandson was saying, "But Mimi, I got away. I got away from him." I said, "Baby, you didn't do that on your own." I said, during that time, I said, early that morning, Lord, me had me praying, loosing war angels for y'all. And we have to loose the angels. God has given us authority to loose them to protect our children, our grandchildren, and not just ours, but other people that we know. And I had to give God the glory for saving my grandson, for not being kidnapped. And all, I'm just giving you some examples of what God can do if we get up and be on our watch. Also, this is a time of seeking direction and asking for strength and purpose in our lives. God, what would you have me to do today? I put it like this. I said, Lord, what is my marching orders for the day? Because we are soldiers in the army of God, and we are supposed to get our marching orders every day of what it is you have me to do. Sometimes he'll tell us, you know, to go visit a family member, or to pray for our friends and different things. But whatever the Lord tells you to do, we are to be obedient to it. And I thought about in the Bible, when Paul and Silas, at the midnight hour, they was released from prison. And that was in Acts 16:25. There was a time to pray for provision, you know, in Luke 11:5-13. And Luke 5-13 talks about when a friend comes to your house at midnight to borrow 3 loaves of bread, would you let them in, or would you tell them to go away, don't want to bother me, you know? And I thought about that, you know, I prayed, I saw that in the Word of God. If a friend came to your house at midnight and say, I have some guests and I need some food, would you get up or would you stay in the bed? I don't know, I'm the type of friend, I would get up and probably ask them, do you want me to help you prepare the food? I don't know if everybody feel that way about their friends, but I do, because I feel like they are gifts from God and we should help our brothers out. And then, last but not least, in the third watch, there are some declarations that we need to make and say over our family. One of them, I know that I plead the blood over our family, over our city, over our nation. And when we're pleading the blood, we're coming against all demons and Satan, and who are trying to wreak havoc in our lives of the believers. You know, he tried to stop things or prevent when God gives you a vision, or try to delay it. He can't stop it, but he can delay some things. But we have to get in the Word of God and declare some things over our lives and say, I'm not taken down. I'm going to do what God told me to do. And in Psalms 4:8-8b, it tells us that we're going to dwell in safety, And we know that when God have our back and we're his children, all we have to do is call on him by the Word of God. We can spoil Satan's attack and counsel the things that he's trying to put in operation, oppose any satanic operation. We're to bind things on earth as they bound in heaven, and we're to loose things on earth as they loose in heaven. You know, it's sometime when you believe in God, maybe for a home or for your ministry, you can bind some things up that you see are trying to happen, and you can loose those things that you want to happen, and you bind up the things that you don't want to happen. And we can break all witchcraft and curses and spells and powers of darkness working against us. And we can also cancel Satan's assignment. God has given us authority, but a lot of Christians today are not using their authority. But if you're using your authority, most people who use their authority know who they are in Christ. You know God has given you authority over the enemy. And you, one of my favorites is Psalms 91, when he tells us, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High, and abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I'm abiding in the shadow of the Almighty. He's protecting me. He's keeping me. I'm like a little chick under his wings. And he's bound to God, his children. He told us in his word. And we are to counsel every attack of opposition, depression, and perversion. And we are to stop any hindrances and deceptions, because the enemy can deceive us if we are not on our guard. Deception can come in many ways. Sometimes it can come through some people at church, because we know everyone that's in church is not saved. We know that Jesus said that he's going to let the wheat and the tares grow together, but he's going to do the separating. I had to learn early on when I was a young Christian that everybody in church is not saved, because I used to treat everybody the way I wanted to be treated and be loving and kind and everything. But I found that people will try to set you up. And that's why you have to be on prayerful and on your guard. And God will start showing you who the real enemy is. And we know that the word of God said it's not flesh and blood, but it's principalities. And it's that spirit behind that person. It's not that person. So that's why we are supposed to pray for them. And the Lord tells us to pray for our enemies. All of these things. We're supposed to watch and pray in this day and hour. And we are to give our petition unto the Lord. And he said, our heart, if we delight ourselves in him. And we also know that the word of God tells us in Philippians 4:19, my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. There's something you may be needing today, physically, financially. We all have to do is depend upon our Lord God. And in this third watch hour, I hope and pray that some of you know who you are that's in that hour. No, and I've been even trying to teach my grandchildren about certain hours. If the Lord is waking you up, that's because he's calling you into intercession. At the same time, every morning, he's calling you into intercession. And I don't know about you, but a lot of times what I have to do, even in the beginning, I would be on my knees praying, and Satan would put me to sleep. So I had to get up and start walking and decreeing and declaring. And also during that prayer time, I give thanksgiving. I sing songs in the spirit. And when you finish and you have a good rest in the evening. But it's just a blessing that God called you as a watchman. And I just want to thank God for that. Now I would like to turn you back over to Apostle Murphy.
God bless you. I tell you, this is an awesome teaching you have done. And I mean, strategically done, too, for us to understand what position and authority that we should be in. There's a position in the authority we need to exercise, because this is what the enemy wants. He wants to lay down and slumber and just say, I'm just so tired, it doesn't happen in no way. And that's the devil. No, he gets us in that mode. Our body is just weak and tired. And a lot of times we wear ourselves out and can't get up and fight. And so I just bless God for the message that you have given us today. It's quite powerful. And I also realize that many of the people that who may be seeking prayer, that may be just getting on the call, if they have a special prayer request, we'd like to add that in our closing prayer. So if you're on the call and you have not given us a special prayer request, we'd like to hear from you. And we want to hear any comments that you would like to share from the message today. We'll open the line up for that as well. But I just want to, like I said again, say how blessed I was, how thorough you was on delivering the message. I'm going to give my message about it, and I'll release it to Apostle Carol and anybody else who would like to share. We'd love to hear from you. My heart really flowed heavily when I thought about, like you, in that hour where this witching hour, where the enemy is doing what he wants to do, what it wants to do is what I prefer to call it. I don't give it no gender. No.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing I have seen over the years of warfare is that the Lord will literally give you a dream of war, and you know that you're in the war because you can literally feel that, that tangible presence of an enemy in the room. And I remember laying down on many occasions where I am asleep, and I do not sleep on my back. I sleep on my stomach, and the Lord will literally turn me over, set me up right when it's time for me to war and fight and just quote scriptures and war, literally war, where I can feel the enemy fighting me like a human being. And I would just speak the word and just fight and speak the word, and the thing would go. And one thing we got to know is that God is there with us. Many of us are laying down, allowing the enemy to just overtake us in many fashions. But he will also give you a dream. The Bible tells us in Job 33:15 that he says, and in a dream, a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls upon us. And that's during that hour where the deepness of our sleep is coming. This is why the enemy comes to us. He'll try to give us a dream or those spirits that will come and try to come in and seduce us to think on these nasty things and do things that are not, you know, holy in our sleep. And it says, and while slumbering on their beds, when he opened the ears of men and seals their instructions. What he's saying is that God does that. Once we're in this deep sleep, this is when he comes to give us dreams and visions. I am a dreamer and a visionary. One thing you can get to know, if it's from God, you're going to know it. And you need to write that vision. You need to hear God out of that, because he is trying to shape you to understand something. So that's pretty much when it happens. You know, during this hour, in the same hour also, you know, because it's the witching hour, a lot of people do die during that hour as well. You know, this is always beginning up, and sometimes standing in the gap for our family members who may be out there in them clubs and, you know, about to lose their lives to the death angel. So we've got to be really interceding during this hour. God bless you.
And Dr. Murphy, you're exactly right. I bought me a journal and started putting the prayers in, the dreams in and stuff. And a lot of times what the Lord would do with me when I was even working, 3 days before something would happen, I would have a dream about it. Mm-hmm. And so I already knew what the instructions was and what to do. And those people would always try to figure out, how does she know? How does she know? But God would always give me instructions. Even when people were plotting my demise, trying to get me fired from the job, God would show me the person, show me what their agenda was, and he would tell me how to prepare for it. And when I got in the office or whatever the thing was, I would be ahead of the devil every time. Every time. It was strategic the way the Lord would do it, and I just had to give him the glory. And I stayed there for 27 years. I said, Lord gave me the job, and I'm not leaving it before he tells me to leave. And that's
right.
What I did.
That is right. And one of the things I find with that instruction is that, like you said, it's very strategic. He wants you to say, I'm showing you, and don't do nothing different. Do exactly the way I'm telling you to do it. When he said, don't you open your mouth, don't open your mouth. And many people that may be listening to this are fighting, you know, all kind of demons in these high places on these jobs. But we got to know. God give a job, and only God can shut the door. In the time that he wants shut, ain't no devil in hell going to be able to push you out of that. We push ourselves out of some things that we don't want to fight. Spirit, not in the flesh, in the spirit. And God will show us. Amen. Is there another comment, Dr. Apostle, that you want to share?
Definitely, Dr. Murphy. I have truly, truly been blessed by these lessons. Talking about the gift that came to watch it. And as you were talking, and Dr. Porter did an awesome job, a lot of things coming to my mind that I think, Dr. Murphy, I was about 40 years old before I even realized why I kept waking up during the night. I didn't know, no one had taught me why I was waking up during the night, but I knew to pray. And what I'm saying is, sometimes if you don't even know what to pray about, just go into that prayer lane. You know, part in this prayer in the spirit, because when we pray in the spirit, it uproots all of it. It covers it. That's why people need to know that we need the Holy Spirit. We are the Holy Ghost. That speaking in our prayer language in other tongues. Something else that as you and Dr. Porter were talking, that came to my attention, is when we miss these watches, when you get the tugging in your spirit to get up, to pray, and you be lazy and roll over, somebody's life depends on your obedience to the Lord. And one time the Lord told me, he said, when you don't get up and pray, or when God tugs at your spirit, or you're wide awake, he said, you're sleeping in a dangerous time.
Right.
And we have to be careful of that. Now, not about how you told us, in the spirit, God will show you, as Dr. Porter said, the things to come. And then the ears that we can clearly, you know, sometimes people will say, something told me. Well, if you know the voice of God, He is not a something. Mm-hmm. The Spirit of the Lord impressed upon me. And so sometimes we can find all kind of excuses not to get on the prayer line. I mean, to learn about these different watches. Because when I wake up at different times sometimes, I run and grab that paper. So I know, you know, usually going on during that particular time of night. And it was something, sometimes you may just wake up in tears.
Mm-hmm.
And when you wake up in tears, you don't know what it is. Sometimes I wake up, as you say, Dr. Mason, sit up in the bed and say, Lord, what is that? What is it? And then I just go off into my prayer language, but you don't ignore. And I may sound elementary, but it was because it was elementary to me. No one had taken the time to teach us that.
Yes.
So it's not just something that we're talking about, but we have to apply them to our lives. And Dr. Mapp, I learned so much, and I'm so grateful that you introduced this to us.
God bless you. This is such a time now, people just don't know. We've got to get some understanding, you know, that we can pray all day long. If you don't even know what to do in war, you just there in war. And, and want the line to be open for others. You're so right. But I've got to say this part when my spirit about the Lord would turn me over and I'd up and be in war. And I think what that strategic move with the Lord did was because over the other, times in my life where I'm trying to wrestle with this thing to get it off of me, fighting me. That's what it was doing. It was the back of my head down and mash it to the mattress so that I couldn't breathe. Sunday, where I couldn't breathe. And so the Lord, what he started doing, I mean, I was literally thinking I was losing my breath. I'm like, Jesus, you're going to let me die here? I can't fight. And he would flip me over. And there I went to war. So this is the hour we got to know that if we're willing and able, because some people they ain't able, but you willing to fight, God will help you fight. And we got to charge angels. I don't want to leave that out. I didn't say that. Charge your angels. You got to charge that angel at night. You got to charge that angel before you walk out that door. You got to charge them angels while you walk around the house, too. As soon as you hear something or see something in the spirit, you got to charge your angel. Call Michael. I've been calling on Michael a lot and say, go, And I just say, help. Send the warring angels. You got to start speaking what you see or what you hear right then. So, oh, now the devil is alive. I charge the warring angel, Michael. Now I shut the gate. Let it go. Shut the gate of death and hell for my baby, some of the situation. We got to immediately start to charge hell. And this hour right here is one that is so keen. But on next Monday, we don't know who our speaker is yet, but this fourth watch, my God, we know that's a dangerous watch. So I'm opening the line up now for the devil because he don't know who we messing with when we get up in that fourth watch out. Is there another comment? Anybody want to comment? The phones are not on mute. You can take your own stuff off mute if you put yourself on. We want to hear if God has spoken to you or give us any revelation.
Amen.
We don't have any.
Praise the Apostle.
Hi there.
Apostle.
Hi.
Praise him. Good morning.
Hi.
This is Javon Criswell. Just wanted to have y'all pray for me. Just went through breast cancer surgery. Yeah, God is good. My mother's were benign and hers were bigger, so I was in a little bit of denial, but praise God.
From you. I had just been a while.
Yes, ma'am.
What's going on? So glad you got the number.
Amen. And God woke me up. I was listening to what she was saying. At 5:30, God woke me up, and I looked, and the first thing I saw was prayer at 6. So I said, okay, Lord, I'm praying until 6 o'clock because I already know I'm already up. And I'm always on the prayer line at 6 a.m., on someone's prayer line at 6 a.m.
Yeah.
So I was thankful to God that I heard this because, some things are just for you. So this was for me. Praise him.
Praise the Lord. We're going to be interceding in just a few minutes and making sure that we let the devil know that God is still a healer and his blood still works.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Is there another on the phone that has a comment or would like a special prayer request at the close?
And Dr. Major, I'd like to encourage people to call people and remind them again. Tell somebody, because it's important that we know about these watches.
Yes,
and
Lord.
It's worth the sacrifice of sleep.
Yes, Lord.
Dr. Mother, good morning.
Good morning.
I just want to praise the Lord and give him glory for what he is doing on the prayer calls and through you and the other ladies that have taken the baton and are pressing on in Jesus' name. So many people are perishing, as the Bible says, for lack of knowledge. So many people haven't been taught about these watches, and the devil is just having heyday havoc in our lives. So I just give God the praise. I endeavor to learn more, because I will not in the name of Jesus. And I just ask y'all to keep me lifted in prayer as I persevere, as I go forward for the kingdom.
Yes, Lord. We definitely have your name on the original list and continue to press forward in the things of God, because we know that, like we said early on, that's what he wants. He wants to just get so overwhelmed. I think I sent out a message about that on Saturday when I got here, but it was the grief, those silent things that we don't get with people who we know won't be taken all around everywhere on Facebook. It's the people who truly love you. And I think that's what it was. I was in the silent grief of my friend. You know, my God, I'm my confidant.
Yes.
But he was reminding me that I had to deal with that grief. You know,
that
you don't realize, so then you start to just fold in on you and the cares.
Yes.
And then here I am going, what's wrong with me? Why am I crying?
Uh-huh.
What it was, because the things that I would usually call my confidant about, I had nobody to do that with right away. You know, I just look around and say, look, you need to be friends about this here, this, that. And then she'll say, oh, yeah, add this to your list. But see, this is the thing. We got to have somebody to pick the phone up quickly about. We know our daddy's saying, come to me. But he's also giving us people on earth that we can release these to. And so we've got to be in agreement, and we both charge heaven, you know, when we're on that call. Immediately, we don't say, okay, I got it. No, we immediately start charging heaven. You know, and I hope I'm cheap, you can't find like that, 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. That's what she was. I'd get on the phone, call her, she'd answer. I don't care if she has sleep. No, what is it? Oh, yeah, wait a minute, let's pray. And we just go to walk. And so this is where we need to be in for such a time as this. So anybody else got anything else for Apostle Praise?
Dr. Murphy, I just received a notice to pray for the family of Joanne Williams. Joanne Williams just died of cancer. And we need to pray for hold that family up. And also that God would send forth laborers to use their favor to get them a place to live there in search of a home.
Okay. Yes, Lord.
Well, I received texts as you all were talking, you know, with regarding some of the prayer requests.
Amen, amen. Anybody else? Okay, if there's no one else, then we hope that you remain on the call after we pray. Dr. Carolyn wants to share a prayer time that you all can be invited to this Saturday. God bless you. Go ahead, Apostle.
Father, we just thank you for the privilege of being able to rise up early and pray. You thank you. God, we thank you that the eyes of our understanding, are being opened right now, and that we are being able to hear clearly what the Spirit is saying to the church. God, we will continue to sound the alarm and to expose the enemy and all of his tactics. We bless you this morning. We thank you. We don't take this time of learning for granted, but we appreciate all the teachings and all the love that has been handed down to us by Apostle Murphy. And God, I pray that you will continue to strengthen her, to be with her, to bless her family, bless her children. And I pray for her son right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, angels of the Lord, and trembling about your people, keep them from all hurt and harm and danger. And we cancel the assignment of the enemy that would like to try to deter us,
Father,
the plans of God. God, we surrender our will, our emotions, everything that concerns your people, and all of those that even have requests or prayer requests that they didn't want to mention over on air. We pray for them, God. We pray for the marriages. We pray for relationships, broken hearts. God, those that are burdened, those that are heavy laden, God, lift up their heads, God. Let their sorrow be turned into joy. We pray that you would send forth skillful laborers in the vineyard to help your people to be able to transition from one level to the other. We're just so humbled, God, that you even chose to speak to our hearts. We're grateful for you, God. We got so much to be thankful for. We thank you that we have a mind to pray and a mind to seek and serve you.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. And we seal all of these requests with the blood of Jesus, angels of the Lord. Go before your people, protect them, and keep them from all hurt, harm, and danger. We cancel out every assignment of the enemy right now. In the name of Jesus, we nullify it, we curse it at the root. It shall not come forth. In Jesus' name, we bless you in advance, and we'll continue to tell of the goodness of the Lord and all the things that you have done and are doing for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, I'd like to make the announcement this coming Saturday. I'm going to be having my spiritual baby. The God has given me the ministry called I Flourish through the direction and the mentoring of Apostle Sandy Murphy. And I'm just so thankful. And so you're invited. Everyone is invited. It's this coming Saturday, September the 24th at 10:30. It is going to be held at Word Under the Stars Church, Pastor Cynthia Carter. The address, it is 14909 Lee Road, 14909 Lee Road, Houston, Texas, zip code 77093. You all are invited. I need you to come and support and help me deliver this baby.
Yes, Lord. It is well overdue. And I'm looking forward to seeing y'all there. Make sure you get there in the beginning of the hour of the Apostolic Press for, I call it, the spiritual stirrup push. Well, to make sure that the atmosphere is charged and we're prepared to fight. So it's not a woman thing. It's men and women are invited to bring their friends. And I wanted to say to Minister Sharon, I hear the Lord saying is over the years, people who I've shared with that are going through these infirmities, and we don't care if they have come down from the generation, because we can repent and then tell hell to go back. God has graced you. So I'm hearing him to tell you what I tell everybody. Just take the Lord's Supper every day and repent for your generation and for any sins or anything that's so easy to say to you, and then just thank God that your body is whole. So far, it ain't never failed. The blood still works. I truly put that to the test when the Lord told me, when they were telling me I was going to die if I didn't do this or that. And I said, well, I'm going to show you something, who Jesus is. And that's what I took the Lord's Supper every day until it was time for me to go back to that doctor, and they couldn't find a thing. Because I told the Lord, how can this be in me and you too? That don't match. Yes, God. That ain't going to work. Not the blood and infirmity, too. So just take that Lord's Supper every day from what the Lord is telling you to say. And I don't know if she's still on the call, but I pray that she'll get a chance to get this message and hear God. Amen?
Amen. And then Sister Yvonne Criswell, we want to continue to pray for her.
Yeah, it's Sharon.
Oh, Sharon,
that's what I was talking about.
So I wrote it down.
It's Sharon. And we already can declare that, you know, for Daniel. Daniel's house is already picked. God is trying, perfectly speaking now, but God is trying to get him to be still so he can show it to him more in a dream. You know, just as the song was going this morning, we can have what we believe in, which is so true, because some things God can't give it to us because he's trying to prepare us to see if we can qualify for it. Does that mean, are you going to be ready for this house? No, are you going to be ready to be able to have these other things that require us to have in a home? You know, so you've got to get you to count the cost and be still and listen. And to prepare, you know, so that means the favor is going to come once he sees you are prepared to know what's required of you when you get a house. And I say that because I remember I asked God for this beautiful house and I got it. But he told me faith can't keep you here. Because I gave the desire in your heart, but now your faith can't keep you here. Because I was every day going over note to note, but yet he paid me, but yet I was still over note. But we got to know that if we hear God, he going to take care of cash checks that he gives and write for us. You can rest assured.
Thank you for those words of wisdom. I definitely will pass it on.
Yes, it's being still and write the vision, make it plain, making sure he write down, you know, because like I said, we didn't get to get houses. Well, who wants to get a house and we can't live in it? It lives on us. I want to live in, not it live on me.
That's
and,
right.
So I bless God that he is getting that house because the faith of God is going to reign, and we praise and we trust God that we're going to obey, and it is already here. It's just him just getting still so the Lord can show him, go here, go there, and it is done.
Okay.
Name.
Thank you.
Amen, amen. Anybody else? All right. When we say join us again on next Monday, same time, 6 a.m. Central, and be sure to share this link when you get it. God bless you.
Thank you. Amen.
Amen.